High Court Legal Services Authority is also another authority constituted under this Act. High Court Legal Services Authority provides for the free legal aid and amicable settlement to dispute in the cases pending before the High Court. It also provides for speedy disposal of dispute through Lok Adalat. It consists of a sitting judge of the High Court who shall be the chairman. Such number of other members possessing such experience and qualification as may be determined by regulation made by state authority to be nominated by the Chief Justice of the High Court. Like National and the State Legal Service Authority, it also provides for the appointment of members from the bench, bar and the social action group. Involvement of member from non-legal background is essential for the mediation and conciliation. Members of this committee are bound to maintain the accounts of the funds received and expenditure incurred on the implementation of provisions of this Act. A dispute comes from the High Court when parties to it were not satisfied from the Sessions Court decision. This type of dispute has covered a long journey of litigation before the courts, and it is in the interest of justice that there should be an end to litigation. So in such type of dispute, mediation, conciliation becomes very essential to put an end to the litigation. District Legal Service Authority. The District Legal Services Authority works at the district level. A District Legal Service Authority consists of district judge who shall be the chairman, such number of other members possessing such qualification and experience as may be prescribed by the state government to be nominated by the government in consultation with the Chief Justice of the High Court. Like other legal service authority, it also provides for the members not only from the legal background but other background as well, so it makes easier for the body to understand the dispute of the parties and settle the dispute amicably. It is bound to do the function assigned to it by the State Legal Services Authority. It may coordinate the activities of the Taluka Service Committee and other legal services committees. It also organizes Lok Adalat within the district. Provision like small tenure of the members and the maintenance of accounts prevent the chances of malpractices in the Legal Services Authority. Many a times it happens that due to ignorance of the right or poverty, people fail to make proper legal representation in their cases, which leads to injustice. So it is in the interest of justice that needy people should get the free legal assistance at the grassroots level. Taluka Legal Services Authority works at the grassroots level. It is a useful mechanism to put an end to dispute at the initial stage, which will save the parties from unnecessary harassment if they fail to settle their dispute at a grassroots level. Legal Service Authorities Act has provided a list of people who are entitled to free legal aid under Section 12 of the Act. These are the people who can claim free legal aid under this Act, and free legal aid has been provided very broad meaning. It includes not only the free services of an advocate, but also exemption from the court fees and the process charges. The people who are entitled for free legal aid under this Act are people of Scheduled Caste and Scheduled Tribe, a victim of trafficking in human being, or a beggar, women and children. Here, we need to understand one point, that women is entitled for free legal aid irrespective of her financial position. It doesn't matter what is her final position. It doesn't matter whether she can afford the legal services or not. If she is a woman, she is entitled for free legal aid under this Act. A person with disability, as defined under Person with Disabilities Act. A person under circumstances of undeserved want, such as being a victim of mass destruction, ethnic violence, caste atrocity, flood, drought, earthquake, or industrial disasters. An industrial worker or a person in custody. Custody includes custody in a protective home. So, if a person is a prisoner, if he is in judicial custody, then he is entitled for free legal aid and no court fees and no advocate services will be charged from such person. A person in receipt of annual income less than Rs 9,000 or such other higher amount as may be prescribed by the state government. If the case is before a court other than the High Court and less than Rs 12,000 or such other higher amount as may be prescribed by the state government, if the case is before the Supreme Court. Person who satisfy any of the criteria mentioned in section 12 will be entitled to free legal aid, provided that the concerned authority is satisfied that he has a prima facie case. An affidavit made by a person as to his income and his falling into any of the categories which makes him entitled to the free legal aid will be sufficient to make him available to the benefits provided under this Act. Supreme Court Middle Income Group Legal Aid Scheme. Supreme Court Middle Income Group Legal Aid Scheme. It was enacted to provide free legal aid to middle income group people. It has two-folded benefits. Firstly, it eliminates the chances of misrepresentation of the income by a middle income group to get the benefits of free legal aid in the Supreme Court, as now it is available to them as well. Secondly, it was realized that nowadays basic necessity of life has become so costly that middle income group hardly remains with any part of income after fulfilling basic needs to invest in their fight for justice. The criteria for providing free legal aid and regulation of proceeding under free legal representation is such that it entitles only those people who actually comes in the category of middle income group. They are adequate provision to prevent the advocate on record from doing its assigned work efficiently. It has also specifically provided that remuneration of advocate on record, which eliminates the chances of any dispute regarding the remuneration to be provided under these schemes. Lok Adalats. As we discussed earlier, the objective of legal service authority is two-folded. One is to provide free legal aid to those people who cannot afford it from their own earning. And secondly, is to speedily dispose of the dispute, and for that, Lok Adalat is the appropriate forum. Indian courts are overburdened with work and it takes years to settle the dispute before the formal court. As we know that justice delayed is justice denied, so need was felt for the constitution of alternate dispute resolution mechanism to settle the dispute speedily and amicably. The Lok Adalat is recognized as one of the alternate dispute resolution mechanism capable of settling the dispute speedily, cheaply and amicably. Its bench consists of members from legal and non-legal background. It is in a better position to understand the dispute of the parties and convincing them to arrive at a settlement. Experience of member from legal background help in understanding the fate of the case if brought before the formal forum, and people from a non-legal background help in convincing the members to come to a compromise or settlement. The legal service authority can organize Lok Adalat at such interval, at such places, on such matters as they deem fit. A person shall not be qualified to be included in the Lok Adalat unless he is a member of a legal profession or a person of repute who is especially interested in the implementation of legal services schemes and programs, or an eminent social worker who is engaged in the upliftment of the weaker section of the society, particularly women, scheduled caste, scheduled tribe and children. The scope of Lok Adalat is very wide to include every possible petty offence and dispute. But Lok Adalat has no jurisdiction in respect of any case or matter relating to an offence not compoundable under any law. The authority or committee organizing the Lok Adalat may, on receipt of an application from any one of the parties to matter, refer such matter to the Lok Adalat for determination. No such matter is referred to Lok Adalat except after giving a reasonable opportunity of being heard to both the parties to dispute. When any case is referred to Lok Adalat, the Lok Adalat proceed to dispose of the case or matter and arrive at a compromise or settlement between the parties. Every Lok Adalat, while determining a dispute before it, will try to encourage the parties to come at compromise or settlement. It is guided by the principle of justice, good play and fairness. It is provided that when no award is made by the Lok Adalat on the ground that no compromise or settlement could be arrived at, then the case file and the records will be sent back to the court from which the case was referred to, and that court will start the proceeding before it from the stage from which that matter was referred to the Lok Adalat. It is also an accepted fact that Justice Harid is Justice Barid. In order to save the time, it need not to follow the formal procedure. It need not to follow the Civil Procedure Code, Criminal Procedure Code, Evidence Act, and it is guided by the principle of natural justice. None of the parties can be forced to compromise before the Lok Adalat if the term of settlement fails to convince them. The award of Lok Adalat is final, so it put in check on the multiplicity of the cases. Once the party to dispute agree to any settlement and they sign an agreement that they settle the dispute as per the settled agreement, then tomorrow they cannot file a case in any other forum, as we all know that there cannot be any appeal against the compromise decree. The provision of finality of award is a good provision to put an end to the litigation, which is in the interest of justice. Power provided to Lok Adalat are sufficient to impart justice without compromising on its quality. Its award is given the status of decree. Its proceeding is deemed to be a judicial proceeding. It is given the status of civil courts, having all the powers regarding summoning, discovery, inspection. On the top of all this, it has the power to specify its own procedure.